Hey, friends of travelers, it's Michael. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this improv session. This is Harriet Island Park in St. Paul. Harriet Island Park has a little bit of history. It's not like a really special or meaningful place for me like some other places that I might choose to play, but Harriet Island Park has a little bit of history. My dad used to take us down here to the annual summer American Legion picnic. It was this huge deal over at the pavilion thing and out in the open fields in the grass here. They used to sell tickets and stuff for corn and soda and hamburgers and all that stuff, hot dogs. And they would have games and activities for the family and the kids. And you know, it was a good time, you know. And of course, I've come down here to Harriet Island for numerous things, concerts. They used to put on fireworks festivals, or like an annual 4th of July thing here. Probably not going to happen this year. They used to have this thing called the Taste of Minnesota, which was a festival. It was kind of a music festival slash food festival slash come eat, do things. They used to hold it up at the Minnesota State Capitol grounds, but I think having the Capitol lawn destroyed every year was not an exciting thing. Literally, I mean, it would get trampled to death, and I think they grew tired of that, and so they moved it down here. And anyway, this place is just, I love it. It's beautiful to me. It's right along the Mississippi River. I'm literally probably 150 feet from the Mississippi River. Actually, technically, I am just feet from the Mississippi River now, which is all of this, all of the grass here, all of the buildings are submerged. So the water is really high. So all of you down south along the Mississippi River, brace yourself. Flooding is on its way. It's already here. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the improv session. You will find it exclusively only at YouTube as well as Bandcamp at stolace.bandcamp.com. I'm not fully, like I'm starting to release less and less on the streaming platforms and focusing more on just creating these pieces and making them available if you want them. But it's becoming less and less of a priority to engage in the capitalist facet of music. I don't care anymore about fame. I don't care about making it, about going viral or being popular or lots of people liking my music. I'm beyond that now. I love creating just simply for the creation aspect of being immersed in this process of making music, and I enjoy the way it makes me feel, and I love sharing it. I love being able to make this available, but it's not my priority. My priority is just to be whole as a person, to be whole as a creator, to make art, music that moves me, and then share it, you know, make it available. But I think, not to get on my soapbox about this, but I'm tired of the dream that everyone tries to sell us as musicians, as artists. The dream of being popular, of making it, of being able to make a living off of your art. And I agree that things should be easier for us to make art and make a living at it, but That's just not the world we live in right now. It isn't. I see a lot of people complaining on the social media platforms about artists should get paid for their art. I don't disagree. But the but in that statement is not very many people want to pay for it. I mean, think about the attitude people have towards streaming music on the platforms. A substantial portion of the listeners out there don't really care about the artist. They care more about themselves, and that's fine. That's the way it should be. But art and music has been commodified so much, and so many variables have been thrown into the mix, into the pot, that have made, that have cheapened music and have cheapened art. Like streaming music, it's so wonderful to be able to have access to everything, but in the end, the artist is the one getting screwed, and they don't get properly compensated. And in the same breath, we as consumers who are consuming all the streaming music, it cheapens it because it's easily available, it's freely, well, not free, but it's available cheaply. So the idea of going out and spending $30 on a vinyl or $35 on a vinyl for myself and other people is great. You know, we're like, yeah, I'm committed to this album, I'm committed to this artist, and I'm showing them my support. But for the average person out there, it's not as enticing. And that's okay. It's okay. I'm at peace with where the music industry is right now, and I'm choosing to participate in my own way. So anyway, gotta finish packing up. Thanks for listening to the improv session. Thank you for your support. It means a lot to me. Take care, my friends. Bye.